A teardrop on the fire. A cloud on the surface of the sun. A snowball in a volcano. A forest trail in crumbs. A momentary aligning, a single grain in the sands of time, stuck right in a geological blink of an eye. A journey that seems to end almost as soon as it's begun. Begun. The tip of the spear of evolutionary legacy flung. The atomic energy in the cells from which you'll become. The incredible difference in efficiency between your dad and your mum. He spawns 400 billion, she makes do with one. Her cell lies in wait to see which of his might arrive. As they swarm and swim a distance equivalent to 9 miles. And out of that horde of hundreds of millions, only one permitted inside. Only one storing the precise data to provide. Only one to create life. Only one selected to answer the egg which has existed though. Since your grandmother was an embryo, waiting patiently formed as a remedy for whatever humanity is set to need evolutionarily. Now unified within a day, the two cells blend fate, exchanging DNA. 46 and 2 just ahead of me. Chromosomes bursting open anew as you, potential human, drift down fallopian tube to find a comfortable side of the uterine wall to reside, embedded in a home with no view, but with symbiotic connection to bring every nourishment through to this teardrop on the fire, this momentary droplet in the rivers, the flow over the waterfall we call existence, this mere instance to be relished between conception and the next adventure of death. May love, the verb, be forever fearless upon your breath.
Love, love is a verb. Love is a doing word. Fearless on my breath. Gentle impulsion shakes me, makes me lighter. Fearless on my breath. Teardrop on the fire. Fearless on my breath.
Witnessing all this, your parents whisper secret superstitious propitiatory prayers to the mist, to a divinity they're not even sure exists. Day 6, a prayer that this embryo sticks, and may your 200 cells be the start of a long life full of bliss. May this neural tube form a fully aligned spine and brain with awareness. May you contribute to a world of increased fairness. Week 3, may you be free, carefree without being careless. And even as you lose your tail, may you not often lose your head. May your life give the gift of patience and the skill of forbearance. And please, please, may we be good parents. Week 4, may you live in balance on the seesaw of the spirit. May the chemicals exchanged between you and your mom all be given the precise signals you need to live life with few physical limits. Week 5, may the million new cells you're forming every minute be the intricate image of harmonious condition, spinning in rhythm with your heart beginning to beat this very instant. Week 6, may you see any weakness you seem to possess as a deep gift. May you possess healthy limbs, and even though they can't see yet, may your eyes provide optimal vision, keep you focused on your chosen mission, and give you the strength of optimism, show you the beauty of truth and equanimous perception. And when the world resembles a prison in an iniquitous system, may you see the locks on the chains and the method to pick 'em. Week 8, may you commence forming ears to listen and hear. May you be capable of choosing love over any decision of fear. May your organs form healthily, may you and nature be friends. May you transition well from embryo to fetus in week 10. May your brain possess respect for love, the verb, master its grammar as a doing and a being word. May your life from birth occur to serve as many tears of joy as any teardrop of pain or sadness. May you be able to see beyond the mere appearance. And please, please, may we be good parents.
Light, light of matter, black flowers blossom, fearless on my breath. Black flowers blossom, fearless on my breath. Teardrop on fire.
From weeks 12 to 20, may you grow well in the belly, preparing for a life that's fulfilling, with some days that are blissfully empty. And whatever you're setting on the gender spectrum be, know that your parents will respect your identity. And if you possess the body parts of a feminine entity, may you have generated plenty healthy eggs of your own already. Week 24, may you be moving your facial features, and may your smile be your favorite expression to greet with. May your fingers be ready to leave their creative mark and bring the spark of your mighty soul's flame to the dark. By week 26, may your ear be ready to hear these very scripts, these ineloquent attempts to ready you for the womb exodus. And may the complex lobes of your brain twist into a formidable tool to solve the equations of this matrix. At 28 weeks, may your eyes take your first glimpse of your womb home, where you'll continue to grow through week 36. And while your mum thinks it's well past the day for you to be born in, you might hang on in the amniotic fluid till week 40, when forcefully you release corticosteroids to induce labor. May your delivery be as routine as any newspaper. May you move away from the umbilical cord.
Don't let it constrict your neck.
May the soothsayers predict an excellent life
from the second of your first breath,
your first cry, your first feed, your first alignment to your earth bearings. May the verb love be forever on your breath, fearless. May you bring the richness of your color to these black flower meadows. And even though every life withers in less than a geological instance, each human a mere droplet in the waterfall of existence, disappearing like a teardrop on the embers, may you enjoy your days on this incredible planet with us, all the precious seconds of your awareness. And please, please, through all this, may we be good parents.